Welcome to the Think Possible Lightbulb Sessions. Here to share how we can preserve colorful Filipino culture through film restoration, please welcome the head of ABS-CBN Film Restoration and Sagip Pelikula Advocacy, Mr. Leo Katigbak.
Ang pag-uusapan natin ngayon ay yung ginagawa ng Sagip Pelikula, yung film restoration. Ngayon, beginning this September until September next year, we are celebrating the century of Philippine cinema. So that means 100 taon na tayong gumagawa ng pelikula. Ang unang officially na pelikula as we know it was Dalagang Bukid last 1919. Tapos ang difference lang, over time, while shooting on film was the dominant means of making movies, by the early 2000, the availability of digital technology started the shift already. So as early as mga 2001, 2002, the indie movies that were being done and even some of the movies of Star Cinema were already being done digitally. By 2008, Viva and Regal had already shifted entirely to digital. And in fact, the last three movies that were shot on film were the three movies of Star Cinema: The Mistress, One More Try, and This Guy's in Love with You. So after that, entirely everything has been shifted to digital. Pero for the purposes of our discussion, when I say movies, I'll refer to film, things that were shot on film. Now, the Philippines has had a very, very prolific history of making cinema. Pero makikita nyo, pagdating ng mga 2010, kahit marami pang mga, or the year 2000 onwards, kahit marami pang pelikulang pinoproduce, karamihan dito ay digital na, kaya konti na lang yung shot on film by 2010 onwards. Pero makikita nyo, shortly after the war, nag-increase ang production ng Philippine movies all the way until the 90s. At ang nagpabagsak niyan was the Asian economic crisis. At saka nung ang exchange rate ay tumalon. Kasi ang film stock went from, isipin nyo, ang exchange rate was 24 pesos to the dollar, naging 56 to the dollar. So everybody was shooting films, suddenly had their cost doubling or tripling up. Lalo na yung mga director na makonsumo sa negatibo. Okay? Now, laging sinasabi na there are two golden ages for Philippine cinema. Ang unang-una was shortly after the war, at ang big four na tinatawag noon was LVN, Sampaguita, Premier, at saka Lebran. Now, the second golden age of Philippine cinema, nangyari yan in the 70s. And I think most people acknowledge it kasi ito yung kasagsagan ng martial law. So, ang daming ipinagbabawal ng mga topics, ng mga material ng gobyerno. Dadaan ka sa Board of Censors, hindi pa Board of Review. Pagkatapos, hihindihan nila. So, our directors and our writers had to be creative. They had to work around the confines of government regulation, pero at the same time, gusto pa rin nilang masabi at maikwento yung mga gusto nilang political commentary, nakabalot lang sa iba. And dito, sumikat ang mga works ni na Ismael Bernal, ni na Lino Broca, ni na Eddie Romero, ni na Mike De Leon. So tayo, medyo maswerte tayo that in the restoration that we're doing, mas marami-rami pa yung nakukuha from this era because it's not that far back. Ngayon, ang isang tinatanong sa atin lagi, bakit ba dito sa Philippines, pag sinabi natin na restored o classic, we're really just talking about 50 years. Hindi katulad when you talk about Australia or Japan or the US, na talagang literally from the 1900s or the 1800s, they actually have materials that are surviving. There are basic reasons why dito sa Philippines mas mahirap. Unang-una, weather. Our weather is really not conducive to preservation. It's way too humid, it's way too wet. So for example, kung ikaw ay gumawa ng pelikula, para ma-store mo siya properly, kakagastos ka ng medyo malaki. Ngayon, at that time, lalo na nung 60s and 70s, okay, sabi nila, sige, pinalabas ang pelikula sa sinihan. Ang susunod was television. Wala pa namang cable noon, walang digital noon. So kung ikaw yung nagmay-ari ng pelikula, ang laki ng gagastusin mo at wala ka nang nakikita na revenues coming in. So because of that, walang aftermarket, producers mismo ang sumisira doon sa mga material. Pag alimbawa, ipinalabas na yan sa probinsya, hindi na nila hihingiin yung mga prints niyan. Ibebenta na lang yan by tonnage. Pagkatapos siguro kung kakausapin nyo ang mga lolo o mga parents nyo na lumaki sa probinsya, matatandaan pa nila na during the New Year, the noise makers were the torotots that were coming from all of these materials. Pag-usapan lang natin yung film. I don't know how many, I guess if you're film majors, you'd be familiar with film, no? But for a lot of people, they're not even aware, for example. But this is how film looks like. So most people aren't familiar. Yung isa dito is a print negative. The other one is a positive. Ang difference, and I'll show it around. Ito sa positive, makikita nyo yung sound sa side. Yung sa print, it's really just the images. So if you wanna pass that around. But I'm sure pretty much all of you would be familiar. Now, ang film, nagpalit-palit yan over time. Originally, nitrate stock ang ginagamit nila. Nitrate was high in silver, but it was also very highly combustible. Kaya ang dami rin doon sa mga laboratories o kaya mga nagtatago ng pelikula, nakasunog. Kasi madali siya mag-ignite. Ngayon, acetate, yan yung naging mas popular, and that's where a lot of the movies from the 70s and the 80s are there. Ang problema mo naman sa acetate, yan yung tinatawag na nagsasuffer from vinegar syndrome. So I will let you do the honors of opening this can so that you can find out how vinegar syndrome smells. And can you imagine, ito, konti lang to ha, you're talking of one reel. Ngayon, di ba nakita nyo sa dyaryo recently, you can open it, it's not that mabaho naman. Na ang UP nag-turnover na sa FDCP ng mga material. Tapos nakita nyo, di ba nakamaskara yung mga tao. A lot of... a lot of the films, ganyan yung condition, lalo na pag hindi maganda ang pagkakatago niya. Imagine when ABS-CBN got the Dolphy titles, when we entered the vaults nung kay Dolphy, you're talking, ganyan yung amoy, ganyan kalakas for just one reel. You're talking of over hundreds of reels na concentrated na ganyan. So literally, didikit talaga sa'yo yung amoy nung vinegar syndrome. And ang problema sa vinegar syndrome, once it starts, you cannot reverse it. You can slow it down, but you cannot reverse it. Kaya more often than not, yung restoration dati, kung may nagvi-vinegar syndrome na ang print, ililipat nila yan to another acetate print na hindi nagvi-vinegar syndrome pa. Now, after that, yung towards the end, before nag-shift to digital, naging polyester siya. Ang maganda naman sa polyester, matigas. Kaya lang ang problema, nakakasira siya ng projector. Pero mas ano siya, mas hindi na siya nasisira, hindi siya prone to vinegar syndrome, pero yun nga, malutong siya. Now, when you look at films that were shot on acetate, and hindi na nga nitrate, kasi dito, ni walang nag-handle na ng nitrate. A lot of the older movies, lalo na kung hindi maganda yung pagkaka-preserve nila, nagiging ganito na yung itsura niya. So in fact, when we were trying to restore Moral, before we were able to find a print of Moral that we could restore, ito yung condition ng Moral when we were borrowing it before. So a lot of the reels had already melted, a lot of the film stock had already melted, tumatagas na. This was also the same problem we had with pagputi ng uwak and pagitim ng tagak. When we talked to Vilma before, Vilma was so happy that we were gonna restore it. Nung nakakita kami ng pelikula, nung lata mismo, nung binuksan, natutunaw na siya. So ngayon, anong nangyari dyan? Wala tayong magagandang kopya ng mga pelikula na Pilipino, yung mga kinalakihan natin, yung mga sanay tayo na mga maraming scratches. Pero yung mga tao ngayon, sanay na sila sa HD, sanay na sila sa 2K, sa 4K. So kung halimbawa, all things being equal, ikaw ba pagtsatsagaan mo ang Pilipino movie kahit gaano kaganda, kung pagkalabu-labu naman siya? Whereas itong B-movie galing sa Amerika, ang pagkalutong-lutong na ng video. So to us, that was the saddest part. People were turning away from a lot of the movies. They didn't care to watch the movies anymore. But at the same time, because of that, they started forgetting sina Broca, sina Ishma, sina Mike De Leon. And when you think about it, we celebrate so much all of our victories abroad in foreign festivals with Sina Love and Sina Brillante and a lot of the movies coming from indie cinema. Pero nakakalimutan natin that back in the 70s and the 80s, we were already the toast of Europe. We were going against the likes of mga Bertolucci and Fellini. I mean, our movies were holding their own. So that's where ABS-CBN's film restoration campaign comes in. Now, what we basically do is we digitally restore and we remaster the movies. But these are the words that we often also use. So preservation, basically, you prevent further deterioration of the movie. Restoration naman is what we're trying to bring it back to how the creators envisioned it to be. Yung revisionism is you're adding elements to it. And to a certain extent, we do that. But revisionism basically is if it's a silent movie, you add sound. If it's a black and white movie, you add color. Or if you're George Lucas, you add aliens and spaceships and to Star Wars. In the case of ABS-CBN film restoration, what we do is sometimes we have to change the music because we cannot clear the music. You have to remember also, a lot of the times in the 70s, people were not respecting IP. So you would hear songs of Barry Manilow and Barbara Streisand, playing in the background, ambient lang yan. And if you don't replace that, can you imagine, the cost of paying those music rights will be even higher than the cost of the restoration because you're using such name artists. Now, what we do with restoration is basically, simply, you scan the films, dati HD, tapos nagiging 2K, nagiging 4K. Right now, the standard is you scan in 4K, you restore in 2K. Pagkatapos, we do the restoration, that's the frame by frame, and then we do the color grading to make the corrections. And that element of it, we don't do in-house. It's outsourced to companies like Retrovata in Bologna, which is the company that Martin Scorsese uses, Cantana in India and in Thailand, and we also work with companies in Japan, and also Central Digital Lab here in the Philippines. As I said earlier, problema namin accessing the negatives and the prints. So in some instances, we've actually had to source the materials from archives outside of the Philippines. So the British Film Institute, o kaya the Singapore Archives, or the Fukuoka Archives. Lalo na kung halimbawa, ano siya, archive siya na nag-turn over ng preservation copy ang producer during one of the festivals. So sometimes that's what happens. Now, ABS-CBN, by the end of 2019, would have restored 185 movies. While the bulk of it is Star Cinema, there's actually a lot of movies there that are non-Star Cinema. So nung una, nag-umpisa kami ng HD, then when we were able to buy our own scanner, we were able to start scanning in 4K, but at the same time, when we started working with the likes of Retrovata and Cantana, sila, they were already at 4K. So all of our restorations moving forward were shifted na to 4K scans and 2K restoration. The idea of restoration is very, very simple for us. It's make the old look new again. So over the next few slides, you will see the things that we have done for the restoration. Fixing the color, removing the scratches, fixing the tape marks, warpage, image jitter. So makikita nyo, yung iba mukhang simple lang eh. Halimbawa, katulad yan, mga molds and fungus lang. Pero may mga iba na mas komplikado na nagwa-warp yung image. And you have to remember, this is done frame by frame. So there are 24 frames a second, then you just multiply it by the length of the movie. It's possible that for a single frame of film, you're actually doing several hours work. Kasi it's not just the scratch, it's the warpage, it's the color, it's the hole. So it's replacing the different elements. So this is from Virgin People. So can you imagine yung lilinisin mo para maging ganyan yan? This is from mga Bilanggong Birhen, which we will be unveiling pretty soon. So nakikita nyo, yung iba mas simple, nag-fade lang siya and color grading will fix it. And minsan, ang nagiging problema dyan, pag nag-color grade ka, mas may lalabas na problema na dati hindi mo nakikita. So in fact, kadalasan, inuuna ang color grading bago ang restoration. Kasi kung hindi, magre-restore ka, tapos nag-grade, tapos, ay, hindi pala natin naayos yun, babalikan mo. So makikita nyo, frame by frame. So pag ganun kasama ang image, ganun kahirap yung aayusin mo. Now, not all of the movies we can restore. Sometimes it's a rights issue, sometimes it's also age. But for the movies, lalo na yung mga black and whites, like the LVN, what we're trying to do is we're doing brand new scans of the movies. So this is a brand new scan of Ibong Adarna from 1941. And then what we tried to do is, this is one of the first movies that were also colored. Pero it was hand-painted colored. Tuwing lumalabas yung Adarna bird, it's the colors of the rainbow. So, as part of what we're doing, it's not a full-on restoration, but we're recoloring the elements. But you know, we could have done something more elaborate, but we also wanted to approximate ano ba yung ginawa noon. Hindi mo rin naman pwedeng masyadong i-advance. So, ito yung ano, combined image. And Cinema One aired this. Now, yung sa amin kasi, it's a two-pronged step, ano. Restoration is just one element of it. But what sets us apart from a lot of other restoration endeavors from around the world, sila kasi pagkatapos sa restore ang pelikula, binabalik na sa vault, there'll be a handful of screenings, tapos wala na. From the very beginning, yung sa akin kasi ang stand ko, kung magre-restore ako, dapat mapanood yan ng tao. That's why we're going through so many different things. Eh. We're tapping the infrastructure that ABS-CBN has. So, but we're not limiting it to ABS-CBN. We're also in Amazon. We're also in iTunes. We're tying up with cinemas like Ayara and Rockwell and the micro cinemas. Kasi ang hinahabol namin, okay, you're restoring the movies, but you're also reintroducing it to a new generation. A new generation that is not familiar with the movies. So ang mangyayari dyan, medyo pahirapan yan. Lagi ko nga sinasabi, when we talk about local movies, film restoration is at the bottom of the totem pole. You have your mainstream movies, your big blockbuster, you have your festival movies, you have your indie movies, and you have film restoration at the bottom. So bago kami piliin, pipiliin muna lahat ng iba. So we have to work doubly hard. And that's why we came up with the Sagip Pelikula campaign. While the restoration has been going on, we felt that we needed a handle so that mas madaling mag-latch on ang manonood at ang audience dun sa ginagawa namin. So, Sagip Pelikula was born in 2016. Just this June, we won our second International Gold Quill for the advocacy efforts. So, nakakatuwa that even internationally, a lot of what we're doing is appreciated. Why do we need to save our film? Now, syempre, ang obvious dyan yung mga classics. But we wanted to drill down, so we looked at ano ba yung mga iba't ibang definition ng classics, and then we will add up to it, add on to it. So ito yung mga lumabas, and so makita nyo it's kind of far-reaching. But as we defined it, ito ang criteria namin for restoring the movies. Now, just to add, it's not in the slide, no? Our campaign has always been, by design, the way we looked at it, we wanted it director-centric. Kasi kung director-centric siya, ang daming mga director. Ngayon, pag tinry mong mag-restore ng works ng iba't ibang director, you will have a better cross-section. Kasi ang artista, nagko-crossover naman. Ang writers, nagko-crossover sa kanila. Pero yung mga director, mas may distinct na vision. So ang nangyayari dyan, we're trying to look at works of different directors, preserve as diverse as we can, and then to the extent that we can preserve works of individual directors more, we'll do that. So we look at this criteria as our official criteria. Obviously, the awards and the recognition. Some movies may not have won a lot of awards, but it may have historical significance. Was it maybe about the EDSA Revolution or something else? But to me, it was also important that films that that marked in as far as the audience was concerned, yung mga nag-box office hit, ipipreserve mo. Kasi while the information is not on screen, the information is in why they worked, in the psychology behind it. And then obviously, Filipinos are not very good at documenting. That's the sad. I mean, you look at the US, even a show like Friends has so many books written about it. Pero yung sa atin, about Insiang, about LVN, about Sampaguita, siguro there's one book written about it, but there's so many other stories to tell. Eh, sa akin, kung wala na yung mga magkukwento, hopefully, maybe some of the movies will be able to tell the story in different dimensions. So yun yung naging criteria namin. So, and as far as excellence is concerned, that's the no-brainer. You have your Brocas and your Bernals and your Mike De Leons and your Eddie Romeros. And we had the ability to pick among their titles. Now, for example, with Celso Ad Castillo, would Virgin People have been my preferred first film? No, I would have preferred Burlesque Queen, but until now, we cannot find a copy of Burlesque Queen. And the copy of Tag-ulan sa Tag-araw only surfaced about 2 years ago. So, minsan may mga ganun kang considerations. Mike De Leon, Hindi Nahahati ang Langit was the first movie we restored because a lot of the others were inaccessible to us at that time. So, yun. So, with each of the directors that we've identified, and we identified a lot of directors, nakalista yung mga pelikula. Tapos, nandun yung priority namin, pero realistically, alin ba yung pwede naming unahin? So, those were part of the consideration. Cinema reflects our architecture. Saka na makakakita ng image, for example, na Quezon Memorial Circle na halos wala pang tao or wala pang mga building masyado. So this is a scene from Ikaw Ay Akin, Christopher De Leon para shoots. Pagkatapos, that's an aerial shot of that one. So yun yung mga hinahabol namin. A Makati or an EDSA, that's not as horrifically burdened by traffic. A Pasig River, na even if it was polluted, it's not as polluted until Gina came into the picture. And then, you know, other locations. It also reflects fashion. So whether the film is set in contemporary times or a period piece, minsan nga yung iba sa pelikula na lang nagre-research eh. Kasi wala na silang makita in the literature. So, katulad dito, this is probably something that's more accurate from the time of sina Tessie Quintana and sina Rosa Rosal when they were doing, because this was present set at the time that it was shot. So, tapos katulad dito, kung sina sa US meron mga Peter Fonda at saka mga James Dean na rebellious 60s, eh di ba tayo, we had sina Eddie Mesa at saka, you know, the other actors. So, we were also adapting it eh. So makikita mo pa rin yung look nila. It also reflects society, culture, and history. So whether it's our faith, belief in Himala, or for example, when you're in the province, yung mga naglalabay yung mga tao sa tabi ng ilog, o kaya yung halimbawa, from ganito kami noon, ito kasi ni-research ni Eddie Romero, ganyan siguro, ganyan yung takbo ng buhay. At least kahit papano, meron tayong makikita na images from that era in the absence of real film from that era. Yung culture natin ng Harana. So you have Harana that's somewhat modern, and then you have Harana set in the provinces. Pero katulad sa atin, if you look at it, the LGBT issues are so noisy in the States right now. But Dolphy was doing that way back in the 70s to box office success. You had Nora and Vilma coming out as in a lesbian love story in T-Bird at Ako. Pagkatapos, even a story like Moral, saan ka makakakita ng pelikulang gagawin na gano'n na ngayon na ang mga bida mo, sina Sandy Andulong, sina Lorna Tolentino. Parang even before, we were daring and people have forgotten that. They remember the rom-coms, they remember the comedies. They've forgotten that we actually had very, very good movies that were trailblazing at the time. To me, this is actually the most important. And people, I guess because of the political situation, ang Pilipino kasi, hindi tayo, minsan ang feeling ko, hindi tayo natututo dun sa lessons of history. That's why it's important that these things get documented. Ang cinema also reflects the reality that we have. Ano man pinapanood ng tao at bakit nila pinapanood? Pagkatapos, sinasabi rin yan, dahil yan yung pinapanood mo, yan rin ang pagkatao mo. At posibleng yan yung mga pupuntahan mo. Just as a case in point, you have a movie that's ganito kamin on, set in the winning days of the Spanish-American War. You have a movie like Tatlong Taong Walang Diyos, set during World War II. After screening the movie, a lot of the comments from people coming out was, grabe, yung isa 100 years ago, yung isa 50 years ago, eh bakit parang ganyan pa rin yung mga pinoproblema natin? So, it kind of makes you think na, teka sabi, hindi ba talaga tayo umuusan, hindi tayo natututo? So to me, that's very, very important as a context. This one is not academic at all, but this is something that we came up with because we felt that if you love films and if you drill down into films, you'll understand our cinematic psychology. Now, noong 1920s to 1950s, ang influence natin was Hollywood. Eh di ba sa Hollywood, dyan na uso yung kanilang mga Spanish because of the adjacency of California and Mexico. Pagkatapos tayo, gumagawa rin tayo ng mga ganun eh. Gumagawa tayo ng mga epic natin na fantasy, yung mga Ibong Adarna. Diba? Pagkatapos, nung 1960, sabi ko nga, yung youth culture, dyan na uso yung mga bangsyanga lang. Pero diba sa Amerika rin, gumagawa rin sila ng mga pelikula na may mga sayawan. The 70s, obviously, because of martial law, we had a more distinct flavor. We were looking at telling our stories outside of the parameters of the Board of Censors. But you know, after martial law, people looked for escapist fare. Kaya nung 80s, di ba, nauso yung mga adaptation ng mga comics nila ni Risa Cabral. Sinasamba kita, paano ba ang mangarap? Kasi isipin mo, 20 taon ang dinaanan mo na naghihikahus ka at naghihirap ka. Gusto mo escapist. Gusto mong pinag-aawayan ni Vilma at si Lorna ang isang lalaki, pero yung isang lalaki, iba yung mahal. Yung mga ganun na kwento. Tapos, itong 1990s, I think this is a transition because the Philippine audience was getting younger and younger. So nung nausa yung rom-com, kaya pag tinignan nyo ang statistics, by the 90s, ang age median ng Philippines bumababa. I think it was about 25. Remember, after the war, we only had 14 million people. Wala pang 100 years, we're already at 110 million people. So it just shows you that on a generational basis, our population was doubling. So if you do a count, which is what we did, pagdating mo talaga dito, ang age median mababa na. Ngayon, nung dumating yung 2000, nagko-complain na rin yung mga tao, ano ba yan? Puro rom-com na lang ang nakikita natin. So that's why, di ba, around this area, nag-umpisa na yung mga Sinimalaya, nag-umpisa na yung Cinema One Originals. But there were already indie movies even before the festivals. But it was a protest to the kind of movies that were being shown. Parang sinasabi nila, there's no variety, there's no distinction. When you think about it, a movie like Moral or a movie like Karnal or a movie like Ganito Kamin On, they were all mainstream at the time they were made. If they were made now, they'd be indies because of the sensibility. You'd see them in Sinimalaya or you'd see them in Cinema One Original. Kaya nung around, after the first decade of the year 2000, di ba nauso rin yung maindies? Kasi nagpolarize. People were looking at you, had your big blockbuster movies, pagkatapos at the same you have your indies, hindi ba pwedeng mag-marry yan somewhere in the middle? This is also the time that even in the States, if you were watching it, nawala na yung mga pelikula ni Meg Ryan. Those middle-of-the-road movies that were, say, they would say, budgeted at $40 million. Pero kayo, ang hinahanap ng mga producer, yung mag-grossa ng 100, 200 million. So nawala yon. That went to cable. That went to HBO and all of the others. Tapos ngayon, where are we now? It's either you have a mega blockbuster like Hello, Love, Goodbye, or you have your Avengers or your big sci-fi. But everything else that's also equally interesting, you see it in iWant, you see it in cable, you see it in other platforms. Because if you were to do them for the big screen, hindi na rin naman siya tatauhin. Because people are going to say, ang mahal-mahal lang sine, gusto ko, pag nanood ako sa sine yan, it's worth my time. So ito, we studied this one. Sabi ko nga, it's not academic. Any of you can look at it and debunk it. But us, looking at the movies that we were all familiar with, sabi mo, may makikita ka talagang pattern eh. Kaya lang, it's also very, very telling na nag-iiba ang taste ng audience, nag-iiba ang gusto ng audience, kaya kailangan mag-a-adapt. And end to end, no, the reason we're doing all of this is we feel that it's important to point out so that people will not forget. It's important for academicians, for example, or academics to study it so that they could share it with the next generation. Kasi minsan, a lot of these are just very, very obvious, but unless somebody points it out to you take it for granted. So to us, the whole restoration project is not just preserving the films, but everything that's surrounding the preservation of films. A study on our identity, a study of our history, a study of our culture, a study of pop culture. So to us, that's very, very important because we're a media company and that's the legacy, one of the legacies that we hope to leave behind. And sabi ko nga, I always anchor it that this is a legacy born out of the mantra of ABS, of being in the service of the Filipino people. It will be a record of our history, of our psychology, of our past. And if people are willing to study it, it can be a guide to our future so we can start avoiding repeating the same mistakes.
Films are an enduring legacy of a people and their culture.
Karami ng mga pelikula noon sira-sira ng mga kopya.
However, in the Philippines, the lack of proper storage and care for these films mean that these cultural treasures might not be so lasting after all.
Doon kasi kahit na anong efforts namin to preserve the film, nagfa-fail because of the storage problem.
With the advent of digitalization, ABS-CBN found the perfect opportunity to do its part in preserving an integral part of Filipino heritage.
The restoration campaign is a great legacy of ABS-CBN.
Saludo talaga ako sa project na to. Para bang mag-flashback ako ulit sa kabataan ko while watching.
This is admirable. This is trailblazing. This is very good for Philippine cinema.
For us also to have an understanding of the culture and history of our people.
In the year 2011, ABS-CBN Film Restoration was born. It pioneered the digital restoration and remastering of classic Filipino movies. With more than 150 restored movies and counting, the campaign received overwhelming support from actors and directors, praises from movie critics, and deep appreciation from people through social media. ABS-CBN launched in 2015 the Sagip Pelikula campaign.
It really feels good to see a work restored after so many years. It's so alive.
Habang may panahon, iligtas natin, kultura natin yan, kaluluwa natin yan bilang mga Pilipino.
Na bibigyan halaga yung mga ginawa naming klasiko nung araw.
Mga youth na manonood ngayon, they'll appreciate it more.
Which aims not just to restore classic films, but also to make them available for this generation and the generations to come through different platforms.
Now is the time to watch the films of before and you compare the films of now.
Maraming mga klasiko pelikula na kinakailangan talaga iligtas bago ito matuloy ang makalimutan ng mga tao.
Huwag silang hihinto sa paggawa nito kasi this is the only chance na makakapanood yung generation ngayon.
Ultimately, films are cultural artifacts that reflect who we are as a people and in turn affect who we will become as a nation.
Uplifts the values, cultural and historical awareness, and sense of national pride of Filipino viewers.
Kailangan magmadali na magligtas sa mga pelikulang ito bago tuluyang lahat sila maging turotot o matapon o mapunta sa kung saan man at mawala.
Napakahalaga na alam natin ang kasaysayan ng pelikulang Pilipino.
Maraming movies in the 80s or even before then na talagang kailangan mapanood natin. Not just to appreciate but also to study how they were. Pag pinanood natin ngayon yun, mas matututo pa tayo. Mas ma-appreciate natin yung Philippine filmmaking.
Para sa lahat, para sa kultura natin, para sa identity natin as a Filipino.
That is why ABS-CBN Film Restoration is committed to preserving Philippine cinema. Because we all deserve to see classic films.
In a long nutshell, that's the restoration campaign.